What is the most difficult thing you had to carry on your car? A surfing board, a Christmas tree, maybe your mother-in-law? Imagine you have to transport the blade of a wind turbine from manufacturing site to installation site, a blade that is as long as Big Mac. This is a real operation, and my project tried to simplify it. Now, what I love the most is some sort of philosophical questioning behind. Am I avoiding my enemies, or I try to work with them to make the world a better place? Give me a chance to explain this. Imagine you have a drinking straw, and you try to bend it. After a while, it will fold into two. This behavior is an enemy of structural engineers like me because it makes structures collapse and break sometimes. Now, our blade is just a giant drinking straw. So we want to use our enemy to be able to fold, transport, and unfold. All of it without using the hinge, without breaking the blade, and making sure that it's still structurally strong enough. How? We believe the answer is materials build smartly into a structure built smartly. Key here is stiffness or robustness, which is the resistance of a structure to deformation. If we look at nature, we will see that wood is made of fibers embedded into resins and oriented in different directions depending on where stiffness is needed. The man-made version of this type of structure is known as variable stiffness composite structures. And they, together with our folding enemy, is our plan to achieve our invisible hinge. Up until now, I have looked in detail at the folding enemy. And I have to be honest with you, we're not best friends yet. It's a love-hate relationship. But I have managed to optimize a structure so that we need the least force to be able to fold. This means least possibility of breaking. There is an exciting way ahead, because if we succeed, we won't be able only to fold blades, but maybe aircraft wings or any other similar structure. I would like to leave you with a bigger picture. Nature can adapt to the environment. Just see how beautifully a bird can dance in the wind. It's not the same like the ups and downs during takeoff and landing of a Ryanair flight, right? But there is a research field that studies structures and design structures that are able to react to the environment by changing their shape and their stiffness. These structures are called morphine structures, and my project is just a tiny part of this exciting field that ends up many times befriending with engineering enemies. Thank you.